Approximately 34,000 refugees have fled from the Democratic Republic of Congo, or DRC, to Uganda just this year. In 2016 alone, more than 992,000 people fled Congo due to fighting within the country. According to the Norwegian Refugee Council, the Democratic Republic of Congo has the world's highest number of people fleeing conflict internally. But what led to this violence? At least 70 armed groups are believed to be currently operating in the eastern region of the Democratic Republic of Congo, says the Council on Foreign Relations. Two of the most powerful include the Democratic Forces for the Liberation of Rwanda and the Uganda Allied Democratic Forces. Many Hutus from the Rwandan genocide fled to the Democratic Republic of Congo and joined together to make armed factions. The Congolese government could not control these factions, and the violence only worsened when neighboring governments, including Namibia, Angola, and Zimbabwe, stepped in to support various rebel groups in the Second Congo War. The March 23rd Movement, or M23, contributed to the fighting as well. Although the United Nations and Congolese government worked together to defeat them in 2013, however, the Council on Foreign Relations explains that since M23's defeat, other armed groups have emerged due to general lawlessness, chaos, and weak governance in the eastern DRC. And the Council of Foreign Relations continues that the country's massive resource wealth, estimated to contain $24 trillion of untapped mineral resources, also fuels violence. The mineral trade provides financial means for groups to operate and buy arms. The terrible violence continues into today. These refugees take the risk of crossing Lake Albert into Uganda. They use unsafe rickety boats, says author Ingeborg Karstad of Al Jazeera in her article Fleeing DRC to Uganda, Africa's Other Refugee Crisis. The Congolese refugee population mainly consists of those who fled the First and Second Congo Wars in 1996 to 1997 and 1998 to 2003, says the European Resettlement Network. People in Eastern Democratic Republic of the Congo are facing extreme violence, with mass executions, abductions, mutilations, and rapes being committed almost daily, according to aid workers in Goma, a major city in the Democratic Republic of Congo. Most of the refugees are from the historically persecuted Banyamulenge, Hutu, and Tutsi ethnic groups. Living conditions for most DRC refugees in host countries are harsh, unhealthy, and unsafe. And these conditions are likely to deteriorate furthermore as more refugees flee the DRC. In Uganda, the country hosting the largest proportion of Congolese refugees, the settlements resemble agricultural village life back in the DRC, with small plots available for farming, says the Borgen Project. Education and SGBV, prevention and response services, are also available, which allows refugees to provide work for themselves, even when there are scarce employment opportunities. Thousands of refugees have also flooded into Burundi to escape a fresh outbreak of fighting in the Democratic Republic of Congo. The UNHCR has praised locals for welcoming their traumatized neighbors. The Burundians helped us. They bring us sweet potato and corn to eat. I am very grateful for their hospitality. European Resettlement Network, a majority of the Congolese refugees are resettled to the United States. In Europe, Sweden, and Denmark, they plan to resettle DRC refugees from Uganda within their 2013 annual quotas. Belgium has pledged to resettle Congolese from Burundi, Finland will resettle 150 Congolese refugees from southern Africa, and the Netherlands will resettle Congolese refugees from Rwanda and Uganda. The UN Refugee Agency, or UNHCR, continues to direct efforts to help the Congolese refugees, and some people from the Emergency Telecommunications Cluster are also working with the United Nations to solve the problem.